Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you how you can create a block area into your WordPress website. Let me show you what we will cover in this tutorial. I will show you how to implement a blog page and blog posts into your existing WordPress website. Then we will create our blog post using the Gutenberg editor that comes with WordPress. We will create paragraphs, headers, add images, videos, and we will use advanced free add-ons to get more functionalities into the Gutenberg editor. We will also talk about styling the blog post so we can get the most out of it. Then we will talk about how to publish the blog post or how to schedule it. We will walk over the settings of the blog post, like adding featured images, categories, tags, excerpts, display settings, and more. When we have a few blog posts, we will talk about themes, because every theme has their own blog settings. I will use the free Astra theme in this tutorial. Then we will create the blog page using the Astra theme settings, and after that I will show you how to design your blog page using the free page builder called Elementor. To wrap it up, I will show you how to show the latest blog post on your homepage and in the widget area of your footer. In the description of this video I have timestamps, so if you want to follow a certain part of the tutorial, you can click on the timestamp and you will go directly to that part. If I go too quick for you, you can slow down the speed of the video like this. If you like what you see so far, then please like this video. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related videos. And I would like to say, let's get started. So what you see over here is my website, which has a homepage, an about page, a services page, a portfolio page, and a contact page. If you want to learn how to create this website, then you can go to ferdycorp.com to tutorials, how to make a website for free. And there you have it. But what I want to add is a blog page with blog posts. How can I do that? Well, first I hover over new while I'm logged in. I click on page and I call this the blog page or news or whatever you want to call this. I call this blog. Then I click on publish and on publish. Now I go to appearance, menus, and I want to add the blog page to my menu. I have a menu over here. I select it and I click on add to menu. Now if I scroll down, I see blog over here and I want to put it in front of contact. So I bring it over here. I click on save. And now if I take a look, the blog page is in our menu. What I want to do now, I want to assign the blog posts of this website to the blog page. We need to do that manually. So I go to the dashboard, to settings, reading, and I want to use a static page, which is the home page, and as a post page I want to have the blog page. So I click on save changes now, then I go to the website, and if I click on the blog page, you see nothing. Why do you see nothing? Because we do not have a blog post yet. So we need to create our first blog post. Let's do that by hovering over new and clicking on post. Here we need to create a title for the blog post, and that is really important because you will be found on the title of your blog post. If I search for the seven best free plugins or seven best free plugins for WordPress. What do we see over here? Seven best free opt-in plugins for WordPress. This is the title of this blog post from Daryl Wilson. If I scroll down a bit, you see videos. 47 best plugins for fall 2019. Most are free. Seven best free opt-in plugins for WordPress. There it is again. So you see, when I search for something like this, people will be found based on the title of their blog post. So the title of your blog post need to have a few keywords. In this case, it was free plugins, WordPress, seven. So title is really important. The title for this blog post is As a Man Thinks in His Heart, So Is He. That's a phrase from scripture. And I like that to be the title of the blog post because it contains the summary of what this blog post is all about. So if I search for this, you see it's from the Bible. What does it mean? Here you see it as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. So I could be found over here in a few months or a few weeks, depending on how active my website is or how much people read my blog post and like it and share it. So the title is important. What I can do now, over here I can click on publish and I can click on publish again. And now my blog post is published. So now if I go to the website, I hold control or command on the Mac to go to the website in a new tab. I go to the blog page. What do you see? As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. You see the title, you see that you can leave a comment. There's no category, and it is by the author, Ferdy Korpershoek. The author is Ferdy Korpershoek because over here, if I click on edit my profile, I filled in my first name, my last name, and here at display name publicity, I said select Ferdy Korpershoek. So that's how I am seen. So there's so much more we can do. Right now we have a title. What I want to do now, I want to create the content for the blog post, and it can be text, images, a poll, it can be whatever you want. So what can we do over here? I can start typing. So I have a paragraph over here. Here I can change the word. And if I want to add a new paragraph, I just hit enter. And now I can continue to type. So I have the second paragraph, and how can I see that? Because you see a line around it. So in every paragraph, we can change the style. For this paragraph, I can say I want to bring this to the center or to the right, or make it bold, or make it a heading. So now this whole area is a heading. Well, I want to bring that back to a paragraph, but there's so much more. If I hit enter, I open a new block. That's called a block. So this is a block, a paragraph block, another paragraph block. But this time I can do something else. So if I click on the plus, I see what I use the most: paragraphs, headings, images, quotes, list, gallery, audio, cover, file. Then we have common blocks, a lot of the same ones, but I can also add a video. Then we have formatting, add some code, a table, a verse. Then we can add columns. There's so much we can do over here. And with widgets, we can add and more stuff, embed things. So if I would click on YouTube, I can add a URL. So I go to YouTube and I search for BioBass01 mindset. There it is. Right mouse click, copy the link address. I go to the new post and I paste it over here, and then I click on embed. So now this is not a paragraph, but this is a video, an embedded video from YouTube. What I can do now, over here I see those handles. I can bring this down, this paragraph, and now this paragraph is below the video. So that's how you can create blog posts. So over here I can hit enter, I can start typing the fruit or the root. I hit enter, this is a new paragraph, and I can click over here and I can change it to a heading. I like to use H2 because you can use H1 only once, and the header is in H1, so I use H2. So there's a title, and below that I can add a new text like this. Okay. Awesome. I click on update. Now if I go to the website, I go to the blog page, and now I click over here, and this is our blog post, the paragraph, the video, another paragraph, a title, and two paragraphs. Well, it looks better already, but I think it's a little bit boring. So how can we make this better? If I want to, over here I can click and I can say, you know, the word yourself, I want to emphasize it, so I make it bold. And this word, behave in life, those three words, I want to make them italic. In that way you can change things, or you select it. And there are more options over here. Strike through, like that. If I don't like it, Command Z, and it is back to how it was. There can also be a link, select it. I click over here and I say https://earth.com. Or maybe you have a different blog post, then you can type the different blog post. For instance, in my case, the about page. I click on it. Now this word earth is linking to elementorcity.com/about. I can also open it in a new tab, and then I click here or here, and the link is implemented. Maybe I want to make it bold. I don't do that. I just click on update, refresh the page. Now if I click on Earth, I go in a new tab to the about page. So that's how it works with linking. So if I click over here, here at the right, I see some options. I can change the font size to medium or change the size over here. So if I would say 10, it is really small. I can click on reset. I can say drop the cap. So the first letter of this paragraph, it looks like this. Then there are color settings. I can change the background to something else. I can change the text color. So I say white text color and a dark background. I can go to advanced and I can add CSS classes. I don't use that. I click on update. So now we change the look and feel based on the settings of this paragraph block. So if I go to a different kind of block, for instance, the YouTube block, here are different settings. So based on the block you have opened, this is a heading, you can change the settings of that block. You can align it to the right, to the left, in the center. You can add HTML anchors so people can link to this area in your website. And again, additional CSS class, which we do not use. So in that way, you can style your blog post. What I will do, I will go over here, hit enter, and I create a new title. 5 steps to get a better self image. I hit enter. So there's a new block. I click on the plus and I go for a list. So there's a bullet point and I say start reading books about self improvement. Second one, I hit enter, speak out loud who you want to be. For instance, I am great. I am awesome. I can do this. Over here, hit enter. Fill your life with positive people around you. Enter. Start hanging out with people that like you. And the latest one, don't watch too much TV. Okay, so over here, I click, I change it to a heading H2, perfect. And what I want to do with this video, I want to bring it all the way down. So I click over here. Now it's all the way down. I click on update. And now it's all the way here. So if I refresh the page, we have styled a paragraph. We have our second one, the title, a few paragraphs, and then the list and the video. Well, what else can we do? We can add a few images. If I want to get images for free without getting into problems with copyright stuff, I go to pixabay.com. And since the subject is as a man thinks in his heart, I search for thinking man. And if I think something I like, this one for instance, I click on free download, download it, another robot, click on download. And then I like to rename this to think, or the same text as a man thinks in his heart. So is he. Enter. Over here, I click on the plus. Let me see, where is it? Here's a plus. And I want to search for an image and I want to add an image. Upload. Then I go to the downloads and I click on open. If you want to know more about images, how to optimize them and all that stuff, you can click over here. Now I'll go deeper into that subject. Right now, I just want to use this. So what can I do now? If I would say align it here at the right and I can make it smaller, not that much happens. But if I bring this up, look at that. Now it's interfering with this paragraph. So in that way, we can style our website even better. I make it smaller. And then here at the settings of this block, which is an image block, I can say the width, the height, link it to something, for instance, the media image itself, open in a new tab or not. So there are a few options. You can have a caption if you want to. I don't want that right now. I click on update and we can find more images. For instance, happy people. I grab this one, free download, download. I'm still not a robot. Download. Show in Finder. I rename this to Freedom in Your Mind. And then here, I can click over here on the plus image, upload, Freedom in Your Mind. And maybe I want to align it to the left this time, make it smaller, and bring it up like that. And then here I can have a caption, Freedom in Your Mind. So now if I update it and I refresh the blog post, we have some images which can make our blog post look better. So what we also can do, if you go to ferdycorp.com/UAE, then we can use Ultimate Add-ons, and for Elementor they cost money, but here at our products for Gutenberg, which is the page builder we use, it is free. We can download this for free. So I click on free download and now it's added to our computer. Now I go to my post, I click on update, then I go to plugins, add new, upload plugin, and I can drag this over here. Ultimate Add-ons for Gutenberg. I click on install now. And now I click on activate the plugin and close this. So now it is added. I go to the website, to the blog page, to the blog post, and I click on edit post. And what we will see now, so I scroll down, and if I click on the plus over here, or let me see over here, plus, I close this, I scroll down, here we see Ultimate Add-ons blocks. It's for free, but you see there are so much more possibilities right now. So what I can do, I can go to formatting, or let me see, layout elements, and I can say I want to have three columns. Well, here's the first one. I click on the plus and I go to Ultimate Add-ons and I say I want to have a team member. So here I can change the name, Ferdy Korpershoek. I am the one and only CEO. Then you can have some text about yourself. You can link this to your Facebook page. And then here at the right, we have all those settings. So I can have a team member image selected. This is who I am. Select it, and then it looks like that. I can say I want it to be above or left from the text or right. Image style circle. We can change this, the width of this image. And then for all the things, social links, we can enable them, open them in a new window. Here we can add our Twitter icon, URL HTTPS, Ferdy Korpershoek. .com or Facebook. So facebook.com/ Ferdy Korpershoek. LinkedIn, I can say, you know what, I don't want to use that. So now it's gone. The color settings, I can change the colors. There's so much you can do and it's all for free. How great is that? Well, if I like this, let me see, maybe I can duplicate it. Yes, I can. And then I can maybe drag it here. Yes, like that. Maybe I can go to the settings of the columns and there I can say I want to have three columns and then I can duplicate it one more time. and then I drag this, or I drag this one, it's easier, like that. Update, refresh the page. So with the free page builder called Gutenberg and the free add-ons from Estra, they are called the Gutenberg Ultimate add-ons, we can create something like this for the Korpshoek. So the sky is the limit with Gutenberg and creating blog posts. But now we only discussed the content of this area. There's so much more we can cover. So let's do that. I close this. And over here, let me show you one more time. We can add a YouTube video, a list, a gallery. We can have ultimate add-ons. So team members, advanced heading, post grid, sections, post carousel, info box, testimonials. And you can also search for free Gutenberg blogs. And then you see more of that. And you can import it and make beautiful blog pages and all that stuff. But what I want to talk about now is other options within the Gutenberg builder. As I said before, if I click over here, I see here at blog the options of this area. And if I click on image, you see different settings. If I click on theme, you see different settings. But left from that, you have the document options. So what it says over here, that is that our blog post is visible, it's public. If I click over here, I can change it to private. Yes. And since I'm logged in, I still can see it. But if I would go to this page with Safari, so I go to the blog page, you do not see it. Why? Because it is not public, because we said it should be private. So I put it back to public. You can also protect it with a password, so people need to fill in their password and then they can check it. So if I would say 1, 2, 3, 4, and I click on update, I go to Safari and I refresh the page. I can click on it and it says it's protected. So I say 1, 2, 3, 4, enter. And now we can view the whole blog post. So that's how it works. Then what else? Right now it says it is published this date. If I would bring this back to the 1st of November 2019, what it will say then here at blog. Well, you don't see that when it is published, but you can see it is published and it's not protected anymore. But you see it's available over here. So you don't see the date, you can change it in the customized settings. We'll talk about it later. But if I would say that this will be published the next month, the 1st of December 2019, and I click on update, then you do not see the post. Why? Because now it is scheduled to be published in the future. And that's the great thing about WordPress. You can schedule blog posts. So if you have a really good day, you can create 10 beautiful, valuable blog posts and you can schedule them for every next Friday. And then you have done 10 weeks of work of blog posts in one day. So I bring this back to today. And then if you see tomorrow, it says schedule. And if it's today, it says publish. So when you publish it, it is available. When you schedule it, it will be available on the time that you schedule. I close this. What else? The post format is standard. If you have a blog post that's all about a video that you want to show, you can say video. I just say standard and that's okay. If it's an important blog post, you can also say stick this on top of the blog. So this will also be visible as first blog post, even if there's a more recent one. Update, and you can put it to the trash. Then there are revisions. If you click on that, you can take a look at earlier versions and maybe you say, I want to restore this revision, but I don't use that. So I click on return to the editor. Then we have the permalink. If you go to the settings and permalinks, I don't save it. You should use post name because then it's called elementorcity.com/asamanthinksinhisheart and not all this ugly code. So post name. And then if we go to the posts, all posts, I click on our blog post. Here it said the slug is as a man thinks in his heart, or the permalink as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. So if I take a look at the blog page and I click over here, it's called As a Man Thinks in His Heart, So Is He. I can also say after that 2020, and if I update it and I go to the blog page and I click over here, now you see 2020. So you can change the link over here, and this link is also important because if I search for 7 best free plugins for WordPress and I click over here, then you see over here that's also in the title. So the domain and then this stuff. So that's really important that you do it the same way. So I close the permalink. What else? Categories. Especially when you have a big website, categories are so important. If it says uncategorized and you have a website with 100 blog posts, they're all uncategorized. There's no structure in it. So with categories, you can create a structure. So what I want to do, maybe at Elementor City, I want to talk about web design, about photography, about self-improvement. Well, then those are all categories. So I can say this one is self-improvement. And then I click on add a new category. But if you have a really big website, then you also can create subcategories. So below self-improvement, I can also say, since this scripture from the Bible, I can say teachings from the Bible, something like that. I don't know. And then you can have a parent category, which is self-improvement. And now if I add the new category, it looks like this. They're both checked. What does it mean if I update it and I refresh the page? Over here you see 2 categories. And what happens if in the future you will have a lot of new blog posts and they have the category self-improvement? When you click on self-improvement, then you see all the blog posts that contains the category self-improvement. So that's really nice. And in that way you keep your website structured, even though there can be a lot of blog posts in it. So that's with blog posts. If I take a look at 30corp.com, you see I have categories. So if I click over here and I scroll down, I see, you see I have 3 categories: blog posts, online business, or tutorials. By the way, over here you see send a notification on a post update. So when I check this and I update it, then all the people that are signed up for my website, so if I go to Safari, so if I go to 30corp.com, it can be that they will ask if I want to subscribe to every news item. And when I do so, then I will be put on this OneSignal list. And then the visitor gets a notification over here when I upload a new blog post or I update one and I check this. So right now, a few thousand people will receive a message when I upload a new blog post. So I have a tutorial about that. You can watch it over here. Let's continue now with our tutorial. So that's categories. We have also tags. And tags is actually almost the same principle as categories, only with tags you cannot nest them. So you cannot have subtags or sub-subtags. So what I can say over here, I can say proverbs, comma, and then you see it becomes a tag. I can say self-improvement, comma, and freedom. Now if I update it and I refresh the page, you probably do not see the tags. If I click on it, now you don't see them. You see the categories over here, but you do not see the tags, also not below. Well, I can go to the customizer. I use the Astra theme, which is in my opinion the best free theme to use. I click on blog, archive, and there I can show tags. So if I click on publish, I close this and I go to the blog page. Now I see the tags over here. It does not look that appealing, but it makes a point. If I click on Proverbs, and if I have more blog posts about Proverbs, you see all the blog posts that contains this tag. So in that way, you can use categories and tags. So let's go to the featured image. If I set a featured image, for instance, this one, or this one, this is me in South Africa on honeymoon, and I click on Update, now it becomes more appealing. So if I go to the blog page, I see this image over here. What I prefer is that all my images of featured image have the same aspect ratio. That's not the case with this image. So I can click on it. I can click on edit. And then I can say 16:9. Then I want to make a selection. I select the area. Then I hit this area, this icon. I click on save. So now the aspect ratio is 16 by 9. I click on update. I close this. And now I can close this. Remove. Select it again. And now it's 9020 by 1080. I select it. Update. And now if I refresh it, you'll see it looks like this. So that's better. I want to get rid of those tags. So I go to customize, blog, archive page, tags, publish, close it. So what else? I go to the backend, scroll down, and there's an excerpt. What is an excerpt? Well, here at the blog post overview, you see a text, and then after the word R, you see three dots. That means that this is just the beginning of the blog post. So if I click over here, I see it starts exactly with the same text. What you can do over here at excerpt is you can create your own text. This is an amazing blog post. You should read it and share it. Update. Now, if I go to the overview page, the blog page, it does not show the beginning of the text, but it shows my excerpt. This is an amazing blog post. You should read it and share it. So what I prefer is to use the first alinea and then people can read more. So I go to the document options, to the excerpt, and then paste this text. If I update it and I go to the blog page, you see the first paragraph. I prefer to use the first paragraph. I copy it and then use that. Okay, then there's discussion. Do you want to allow comments? Well, if that is the case, you click on the blog post, you scroll down, and there people can leave a comment. I'm logged in already, so I can type here, but if you're not logged in on my website, then you can fill in your name, email address, website, and your text, and then I need to approve it. Then there's the post attributes. Right now, we have a sidebar here at the right, and here at the left, we see the text, the content of the blog post. I can also say, I want to change the template to full width, and then it looks like this. Without a sidebar, I really don't like this. Or we can even say canvas, and then you do not see a header or a footer. Well, I really don't like this. I don't use it. So I just say default template. Then we have the extra settings, the sidebar. Do I want to have a sidebar? You can say I want to have the sidebar at the left. Refresh. Then it is at the left. I can say I want to have no sidebar. I can say I want to change the look and feel of the blog page. So now it looks like this. No sidebar, and the content is fully from the left to the right. I bring it back to customizer settings and right sidebar or customizer settings. Then I can disable the title over here. So if I disable it, I can disable the header over here. The featured image, this one, the footer bar, and the breadcrumb. So if I disable everything, it looks like this. No header, no featured image, and no footer. So you can decide what you do not want to show. I want to show everything. We can have a transparent header. Enable it. But you need to adjust a few settings if you use Astra theme to see a nice result. So right now I don't use it. I don't like it. So I say customizer settings, update. Awesome. So we have created a blog page. Let me refresh this. A blog page where we see the latest blog post. We see over here our title, our breadcrumb, the content. We have used the blocks from Gutenberg, but also from Ultimate Gutenberg. We discussed a few settings over here, how to publish it. So now I will add a few more blog posts, and then I will show you how we can configure the blog pages and the blog posts pages. So it's a bit later. I added a few blog posts just as I did with this one. So if I go to the blog page, I can close this now. You see recent posts, there are 5 blog posts. If I scroll down, you see an image. There's already a comment. There's the category, the author. There's an excerpt. So that's how it looks. And if I click on it, it looks like this. And below you see the comments. Those look like these. And I can reply on them. So that is great. So if I take a look at the blog page right now, we see our blog post. I added some others to illustrate something because I want to talk about themes. If you take a look at this area, it is displayed this way because of the Astra theme settings. So if I click on customize, then I go to the theme customizer. And if I go to blog, I have blog single post settings over here and blog archive settings. We'll take a look at this later, but I just want to illustrate that every theme has their own settings. So if I turn this off, you see there are no featured images anymore. So if I close this, okay, and I go to the back end, to themes, appearance, themes, I can choose 2020, activate it. And my website will probably look like a mess right now. So if I open this, I go to the blog page. This is the overview of the 2020 theme. So you see it's displayed in a totally different way. So if I would go to the customize settings, then there are no blog settings. So every theme has their own settings. Let me give you one more example. I close this and I say Ocean WP, for instance. It's not found because I need to click on add new and then I need to search for it. I install it and I activate it. I click on blog again, or I refresh the page, and now it also looks different. A little bit more like Astra. This is displayed a different way. You can click on continue reading. The sidebar is displayed a different way with the titles in this area over here. So if I click on continue reading, you see the title over here, you see the breadcrumb. So every theme has their own settings. So let's take a look at the customizer of the Ocean WP theme. Then I scroll down and I go to blog. And if I go to the blog entries, I can display where I want to show the sidebar. So if I say sidebar here at the left, and if I click on the blog page, because right now you see the sidebar is here at the left, or it can have 2 sidebars. So you see every theme has their own display settings. So I like to use the Astra theme, but then you know that every theme, if you use a different theme, the display settings can be different. If your theme has not much settings, but you don't want to switch your theme to a different one, no problem. I will also show you in this tutorial how to use Elementor to create a beautiful blog page overview. So let's go back to the blog page in the Astra theme. So if I take a look at the blog post, we can configure this. So in order to do that, I click on customize. What I want to do first, I want to go to global, to container. Here we have the blog page. There's an overview of the recent blog posts. And we can configure this. And there's also the individual blog posts. And there's a difference between them. There, one full blog post will be shown. So here is the page layout. And then there's the blog posts layout. But there's also the archives layout. And the blog page is an archive page. So if I change something over here, for instance, to content boxed, it changes. So what does it say, content box? It means that the content, this area, is in one big box, this white background over here. And the rest, the sidebar, is not. So if you say box, everything is in boxes, also all the widget areas. Then we have full width contained. That means that there is no box, everything is full width, but the content is contained between the width of 1140. So if I make this site smaller, you see, the content goes not more to the left over here and here, not more to the right. I like that. What I also can do, I can say I want it to be full width and stretched. And that means that the content will adjust to the screen size. So it will be here totally at the left and here the sidebar totally at the right. Well, I don't want that. I prefer boxed. So everything is in boxes, the sidebars and the background. Awesome. The sidebar widgets and this content area. And the same goes for me for the blog post. So if I go to this particular blog post, I also want this to be in boxes. So also here it says boxes. I click on publish and I go back. Then I go to the blog page again. I go back. Then I go to blog over here. Then with the blog archive, which is this page, and I can decide not to show the featured image. So I check this or I uncheck it. And then these featured images will be gone. Well, I like them, so I turn them on. I can also say I don't want to show this, so I turn this off. I turn it on, and I can change the order. You will see it change real time, which I really like. I put it back. So what do I want to show in the metadata? This is the metadata. If I turn this off, you see no comments. So I can turn it on. People can leave a comment. Then there are the categories, two categories over here, and then the author by Ferdy Korpershoek. I can also show the publish date. I can drag it up and I can show the tags. I don't do that. And I leave a comment here below. So that's how I like it. Then over here, we have the content width. You can change it. You can make it smaller if you want to. But I like it as this, so I say default. And then the post content, do we want to show only the excerpt or the whole full content? So now you see all the blog posts in its entirety. Well, I like to show the excerpt only. I scroll down. We can change the archive title. I think it's too big. So I click on the post title and then make it smaller. Like that, you know what, 35. Well, how can you see the archive title? I click on publish first. If I would go to self-improvement, I see all the blog posts that has the category self-improvement. It's only one, but here you see the title. And here we can change the archive title size. So I can make it smaller. I can make it bigger. Let's say 50. So that's how I can change the archive title. I click on publish and then I go back and I go to the single post. So I go to this blog post. Here again, we can change the width. We can make it smaller. I can show or hide the featured image. I can show or hide the title on blog meta. And then here, what kind of meta do I want to show? Well, again, the same things. The date over here, the comments below. And here I also do not want to show the text. I want to have the text in the sidebar. I will show you later how it is done. Do I want to change the size? If I want to, I can do that over here. Publish. Then I go back and I go back and I go to the sidebar. Well, I can say where on the website I want to display a sidebar. The sidebar is this area over here with those widgets. So a sidebar contains widgets. So where they want to show the sidebar, default, no sidebar on all the pages, but on the blog post, right sidebar, archive pages, also right one. I can also say left one or no sidebar. I can change the width of the sidebar, so I can increase it. So now it's a bit bigger. Let's say 27. No, that's too small. 32. Like that. Publish. Then I go back. And then I can go to the widgets over here. There's the main sidebar. But what I prefer is closing this. Then here at the back end, go to widgets. So we see the main sidebar here. This is the sidebar that will be shown on every page that has a sidebar in the website. So if I take a look at the website, the blog page, here you see search and then a recent post. And that's also what you see over here, search, recent post. I don't want to have a search area, so I click over here and I say delete. And now if I refresh this, it's not there. Do I want to have recent comments, archives, categories, meta? Well, I do not want to have recent comments or archives. I do want to have categories. I do not want to have meta. But over here, there are more sidebar widgets that you can add over here. So let me see. I can have a gallery, navigation menu. I can show videos. So let me see. What I want to show here is tags, but I cannot find them. So what can I do now? I can go to plugins, add new, and I search for tag cloud. Here, something like this. Maybe I like that. So I click on categorize tag cloud from WildTrue. Install. Activate. So now I have an extra functionality within my website because of this plugin. So now if I go to appearance, widgets, here at the left, I should be able to find the tag cloud. So I click over here. I want to add this to the main sidebar. It's already checked. So I click on add the widget. So now it's over here. I can say tag cloud or tags. And the taxonomy is tags. I can also say categories, but I prefer tags. Show the tag count. How many items are tagged with this tag? Well, I uncheck this. I click on save. And now if I refresh the page, it looks like this, tags. So if I go back and I say I want to show the tag counts and I refresh the page, there are only and there's only one for everyone. So if I click on ocean, I see all the blog posts with the tag ocean. So in that way, everything is also linking better in the website, which is good for the Google search results. So use tags. As you see, I use personal, goals, flowers, freedom, Elementor, film, etc. So be creative with it. I like this. It's a free add-on for the website. So here we see categories. And if we go to categories, I can also show the post counts, save it, refresh. And here are two for personal. So if I click on personal, the category, you see category personal. I see two blog posts, the first one, the second one, because they are both in the category personal. So in that way, you can categorize your website and link pages to each other. What else can we do over here? Go back to the plugin area, plugin, add new. I can add a Facebook like box or an Instagram like box or Instagram follow area or show your latest Instagram images. I search for Facebook like box. Let me grab this one. I take a look at a lot of installs, a lot of likes, and last updated a short time ago. I click on install now and activate it. Okay, the title is Like Us on Facebook. Then I go to my Facebook page over here. Remove this, copy the link. Do I want to have a border color? No. The width, you see the result over here. So I leave it as it is. Show faces if you want to, yes. Do I want to show my feed? No. Header image, yes. Small header, if I say yes, then smaller, I say no. And the language is English. I click on save. Now it's saved. I go to appearance widgets. So appearance widgets. And then I scroll down. Here's the Facebook like box. And I bring it to the main sidebar. I click on add a widget, or you can just drag it like this. Done. Now I refresh the page, and on every blog page or blog post, you see our Facebook like box. So that's how it works with plugins. I have a video about the 10 best plugins for WordPress, free plugins. You can find it over here. And now if I go to the blog page, you also see it. You also can change the order. So I can say, I want this to be on top. If I refresh the page, it looks like that. Awesome. There's also a different way how to create a blog page. So I will show you how it is done. First, I go to the backend, to the settings, and then to reading. And here we assign the blog page as a post page. I will click on select, so it's not linked anymore to the blog page. I click on save the changes. So now if I go to the home page and then to the blog page, you will see the blog title. That means that from now on, I can create a blog archive page using Elementor. In order to do that, I want to make use of a few free extra elements from Elementor that comes from a third party. So I go to the backend to plugins, add new. Well, first of all, if you don't have Elementor, you can search over here for Elementor. It's an amazing page builder. And then you click on install now and activate. Then I click on add new and I search for essential Elementor elements or essential elements. Should also be fine, I think. Awesome. So I click on essential add-ons for Elementor. A lot of installations already, so updated 2 days ago. I click on activate. And since I see something else, I saw something about happy elements. Excuse me, I should go to add new for plugins, then search for it. And I will add those two. Those are new. And I want to see how it looks. I say no thanks. No thanks. And I close this. So now I want to go to the website again, to the blog page. I click on edit page and I click on edit with Elementor. So we have the basic elements over here. Then we have the general elements also from Elementor itself. And now we see essential add-ons. So advanced accordion, advanced tabs, Caldera forms, call to action, content ticker. So there's a lot of stuff over here, all for free. Then we have happy elements, an info box, a card, an icon box, a review, justify grid. That's awesome. So what I want to do over here, I want to have the most recent blog post. So I can search for blog and you see nothing. So I will search not here at basic because that's from Elementor. I think it's from essential add-ons. Let me show you. Where is it? EA post timeline can be a possibility, or EA post grid. Let me see. Let's go for the EA post grid. I drag it over here. And what we see now, we see our most recent blog posts. And the source is posts. I can also say pages or manual selection. I click on post or select post. I can say I only want to have them from author 30. If you have a multi-author website, I can say I only want to have a certain category, self-improvement, but I want to show them all. Or I can say I only want to have something with a certain tag, certain format. We can exclude posts and pages. I can exclude as man thinks in his heart, and then it will not be shown. How many posts do I want to show per page? Well, how about all of them? I say 12. If I say offset 1, the most recent blog post will not be shown. It will be gone. That is because if I want to, I can create a new area and only show the most recent blog post a different way. I do not do that, so I click over here again and let me see. Offset 0. So the most recent blog post will be shown over here. Order by date or by post ID or random. Well, I like it to be by date. Descending. So the latest one is first. Then we have the layout settings. 4 columns. I like to say 3 columns because then they're a bit bigger. I like that. I can say load more. So yeah, that's what I prefer. If there are more blog posts, I can click over here. More blog post will be loaded. Show the image. Yes, if I turn this off, it will not be shown. Show the title. Yes. Show the excerpt, the text over here. Yes. Excerpt words. Well, if I turn this off, say nothing. So if I would say 500, it will show the whole excerpt, which I prefer. Expansion indicator. If I say there are only 10 words allowed, then you see those 3 dots over here. Well, I say 500 and here I say nothing. Show the read more button over here. No. People can click over here or on the image. Show the read more. No. Show the meta information. That's okay. Meta position at the entry or at the footer. Entry header. Let's say entry footer. So that's the date, the author and the image of the author. Okay, I close this. Then I go to the style. We can have a background color. We can have spacing between all the items. So if I would say 40, it looks like that. Let's say 10 or 20. No, 10 is fine. Do I want to have a border? Which color? Like that. I don't want that, so I say none. We can have a border type, change it to something else. We can have a radius, so if I would say 20, it looks a little bit weird. You see the rounding over here, but here you don't see it, so I don't use this. I say 0. Then we have color and typography. The color of the link, I can change it to one of my favorite colors. When you hover over it, it changes to a different color. We can change the title, we can bring it to the center, we can change the typography. Accept color, this area. Excerpt typography, we can change the text of the metadata. Hover card style, when you hover over it, what should happen? There's a fade in with a color. I like the color to be the purple one. And I change the icon to, let me see, check. Is there a check? There's a check. Insert. You can change that to whatever you want to have. You can change the size, make it bigger. Load more button style. Of course, you want to change the color to a purple one. So it maintains the style of a website. When you hover over it, it should be the darker purple one. And then we can update it. And what I want to do now, I want to go back. Let me see, I want to check it. Then I go to the About page. I want to copy this area. So I click on Edit with Elementor. And I want to save this area as a template. How can I do that? Right mouse click, Save as Template. And I call this About Header or Hero. Save it. Awesome. I can also save this whole page. Then I click over here on the arrow up, Save as Template, About Page Rio, because I use a background image with Rio de Janeiro. Now I open the page in a new tab. I go to the blog page. I click on Edit with Elementor. And now I can click on the plus over here. Click on this icon. Go to My Templates, and I want to have the About Header or the About Page Rio. Insert. I am sure. Okay, awesome. I click on it to change the settings. I go to the style. I don't want to use the image, but I want to use the background overlay, make it fully like that. Change the angle to 90. And then over here, I say blog. Of course, I want this to be a bit less high. So I go to the layout. I say 200. Update. Then I can duplicate this area, drag this down, or if I cannot do that, I can go to the navigator and I drag this section down like this. Wow. Isn't it getting better and better with Elementor? I'm in contact with these guys from Elementor. They say, in my own words, say we've just scratched the surface. There's so much more that is coming. So that is really amazing. Let me call this blog version 2. Blog version 2. And there's also a pro version of Elementor. Let me show you what Elementor Pro is capable of. With Elementor, you can create an amazing website using free elements. With Elementor Pro, you can get a ton of extra elements to take your website to the next level. Besides that, you can create custom headers, custom footers, blog layouts based on category, import pre-made templates. You can even create custom WooCommerce product pages and archive pages. And when you think this is all Elementor Pro has to offer, they come with an amazing pop-up builder. What about creating pages with dynamic content, a role manager, motion effects, mouse effects, and 24/7 support. The sky is the limit and they keep creating amazing new features. And the great thing is, I have a tutorial about all these features. Now is the best time to get Elementor Pro and create websites like you never have created them before. So in order to get Elementor Pro, go to ferdycorp.com/Elementor. That will bring you to elementor.com and then you can go to pricing and choose your package. All the three packages have the same features, but the first package is for one website, the second one is for three websites, and the third one is for 1,000 websites. When you get Elementor Pro through this affiliate link of mine, you don't pay more and I get a commission, so thank you for that. So grab your copy of Elementor Pro today if you want to, and let's make the world a better place by creating better websites. My name is Ferdy. I want to thank you for watching this video. Have a great day. So let's continue with the free version, which is also really amazing. I click over here and I search for posts. Now we have the WordPress recent post. I can drag it over here, but it looks a little bit ugly in my opinion. Then what else? Post. This one is the one we have used over here. And there's a different one, EA post timeline. So that looks like that. We can change it to pages or something else. Let me go to it really quickly. How many posts do I want to show? I want to show them all. No offset. This is all fine. Layout settings. Show load more. Yes, load more. Show the image. Show the title if you want to. You can do that over here. Show the excerpt. No, only the title. Then I go to the style. Timeline bullet color. Well, I like it to be purple. Everything that seems to have a nice color, I want it to be purple. Then I go to typography. The title color is okay. I want to bring it to the center, make it a bit bigger. Change the line height. So in that way you can configure this like this. The more style, of course, change the color. Update. So that's also a way to show your blog post. So there are three ways, so there are of course more ways. There are other plugins that can show blog posts a different way. It's up to you, but these are a few free ways to show it, like the normal WordPress one or the Astra one with the right sidebar and stuff. Then we have this one and we have this one. And if you go to a certain blog post, it will still look the same as it was before with a right sidebar and all that stuff. So since we talked about it, let's go to the homepage. I want to show you a few more things over here. And now I click on edit with Elementor. And if you want to, you can click on the plus over here or here below or over here. I want to duplicate this. And then here I want to click on the plus. So what I want to do, I go over here. I search for posts, widgets. What I want to do, I want to update it. I want to open it clicking on the eye. Then I go to the blog page. I click on edit with Elementor. So over here, right mouse click, copy. Over here, right mouse click, paste. So that's how easy it is. You copy it from here and you paste it somewhere else in the website. And now we can configure it. And in that way, we save ourselves a lot of time because we don't have to make this from scratch again. So what I want to show is the three recent blog posts. So I want to show three posts by date, and that's it. No load more button. So let me see, layout settings, load more. No, what I personally do not like is that this title is too long because now it's in two lines and here's one and one. So it's not aligned perfectly, but you know what? I'm fine with it. Then I click on the plus over here and I want to go for a header and I say most recent blog post. I bring this to the center. I change the style to capitals. Change the color to this one and give it a bit more space. 20, like that. I can go to the backend to plugins. I add a new one and that one is recent posts with thumbnails. And it is from Martin. A lot of installations, a lot of likes, so this one is great. I click on install now, activate. So there it is. Now I go to appearance, widgets, widget area 3, I removed the recent posts. And then let me see over here, recent posts, width, thumbnails, I go for footer area 3, add the widget area. So there are a lot of options. The title can be recent posts, number of posts to show, how about 3, open links in the window, no, show them in random order, no, do not show the current post. So if you are on a certain blog post, that post will not be shown in this widget, which is really nice. You can take a look at how you want to configure this. I think it's all perfect. All categories. Show a thumbnail, of course. If I save this and I refresh the page, it looks like this, and that's a lot better. So we can wrap this up. If we go to the blog page, this is what we have made. If I go to the blog post, as a man thinks in his heart, and I click on edit post, we have created this post using the Gutenberg editor. We talked about paragraphs, blocks, images, styling your blog post, adding different plugins that will give you more functionalities in your website. We talked about the settings of all the individual blog elements, but also the document settings like categories, tags, featured image, schedule, posts, the excerpt, comments, the templates, and the Astra settings over here. Then we create a blog page using the Astra theme, something like this. And I've shown you how to create a blog page using the Elementor Page Builder, something like this, or something like this. And then I showed you how to embed the latest 3 blog posts in your homepage. I want to thank you for watching this video. I hope you learned a ton of stuff. Feel free to leave a comment, to like this video, to subscribe for more upcoming videos, and then you'll see me in the next video. Bye-bye.